We studied artwork by two very different artists today. Booth Alesi used scrap plastic to create his collaged portraits, and the artist McCracken used paint in order to create art that she saw in her mind when she listened to music. One of them is very much representational, meaning it represents something that we see people. The other one was very non-objective, meaning it didn't have any objects in it, but just enjoyed the colors, lines, and shapes. So you have a choice today of what you're going to make, but you have these limited supplies to do it. So we're going to use the chalk in place of the paint, like McCracken, and we're going to use these papers to create our own objects that we can collage onto our papers. The example that I have here is made with very organic shapes, and it is non-representational. You can use your papers to make whatever you want. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm just going to take my papers, and I'm going to take a couple, two or three at a time, and I'm going to cut some shapes. Because I did so many organic shapes last time, I'm going to create more geometric shapes this time by holding the papers together and just cutting some triangles, rectangles. I'm going to use straight lines this time and see what stands out to me. And similarly, where I used a lot of flowing lines in my background for my paper, this time I'm going to use more angular lines and straight lines. And you can cut whatever shapes you want. You can draw whatever shapes you want. What I want you to do is experiment and have fun. And not normally a fan of glue sticks, but because we're short on time, I think that's a great idea. So I'm going to start again with more angular lines this time, and I'm going to kind of cross them over each other. You can start to make something that you know if you want. You can use this, and like the artist McCracken, you could blend colors. Like I said, I want you just to be experimenting and having fun with this and seeing what can happen. Now, this background part is a little bit more, once it's there, it's there. However, these elements that are for collaging can change places a lot. And so you should try them in more than one spot. And I'm really liking this line, but I want it to come on top. And I think I'm going to do a few more of these lines and blend them in. And now I'm going to start building something on top of here. I could be very random and just let my pieces fall. Some artists do that. Some artists see what happens when they just drop shapes onto a surface. Or I could think, I want to create something, and maybe I want to create a creature. So maybe I want some larger shapes, but again, maybe I'm going to do them with angular lines and very geometric shapes. So all of a sudden, I'm seeing some kind of creature forming here. So if I'm going to do a creature, maybe I need to kind of come up with a color theme. And I kind of seem to be doing the orange and red, so I'm going to continue with the orange and red and get a few more geometric shapes here. And I'm just playing as I go. I am not really thinking about much at all. That all of a sudden says a mouth to me. So maybe I'm going to make this into some kind of monster with a mouth facing that way. Now it kind of looks like the head of a different kind of animal. So you see that there are lots of ways to play with this, have fun. You can make it as representational as you like. Ooh, I kind of like that. I like that a lot. Or you can make it as abstract, as non-objective as you want. So, ooh, that kind of looks like horns. So let's say I like this animal. If I wanted to add face features here, I can always go back in with my chalk and I can add some face features. You can make it as fun and fanciful as you want, and then pick up your pieces and glue them down. So again, have fun with this experiment and let's get this done today.